I have a new favorite way to use Anki, and it's called Image Occlusion Enhanced. This is an improvement over Image Occlusion 2.0, which I talked about in a prior video. So I'll be going over the key improvements and how to use it. Stay tuned.
We evaporate the moon's imagination.
What's going on, guys? This is Jay from MedSchoolInsiders.com. First, if you haven't already, check out my video on the Anki flashcard basics and my other video going over Image Occlusion 2.0. What I'm going to be talking to you about in this video is Image Occlusion Enhanced, which is a similar plugin that is improved in almost every way. If you already use Anki, I highly recommend that you check this out. There is a download link in the description below. If you don't use Anki, then refer back to my prior videos on why you should use it. Now, first, one of the great things about this plugin is that it's only about a year old and it's constantly being updated. I believe that the most recent update was only a few weeks ago. And what this means for you is that as Anki and your computer operating system continue to be updated and improved, this plugin is going to keep up and will continue working without any severe bugs. Now, using this plugin is very similar to using Image Occlusion 2.0. If you know how to use that, using this is mostly the same. But I'm going to show you a quick demonstration. So we'll add a new card. We can either import from a file, or we can go to Google Image or some other spot, copy the image to our clipboard, and it'll automatically populate whatever's on your clipboard, like so. Now, as before, to quickly occlude parts of the image, you can draw any shape you want over here. And just to make this quicker, I'm going to press the D button to duplicate. Now, generally speaking, I recommend that you hide all and reveal one, but for a sequential image like this, where you're learning items in a specific order, it's not a bad idea to hide one and reveal all. This might help you, you know, if you have all these images occluded on the citric acid cycle, you're only going to remember the position, but you want to remember the sequence, what comes before, what comes after. So now we've added these five cards, and to quickly show you what that looks like, this is occluded, and all the other ones are showing, etc. Now, one of the great things about the new Image Occlusion Enhanced plugin is that editing is dead simple. So we're gonna press edit on the bottom left, reopen it, and each of these shapes represents a card. So anytime you change or add or remove a shape, you're essentially changing the cards, and it's gonna give you a warning if you do this. So for example, if I make a new one and delete an old one, and press edit cards to confirm, it'll let me know that I'm deleting one card and creating four new ones. I'll say yes. And now when I go to study this, these new cards are going to show. Another thing you can do is actually change the type of occlusion. So like I said before, for sequential, I recommend you hide one and reveal all. Let's say you have the citric acid cycle down and you want to hide all of them and reveal only one. You can do that, like so. Now all of these are hidden, and just one shows at a time. Now similarly, grouping cards together is pretty quick. You just press Shift, select two, and press the G button to group. Press Edit to confirm. I'm going to be deleting two cards and creating one new grouped card, so yes. And that grouping looks like this. There you go. Now another cool feature is you can actually change the image in the background. Let's say your professor updated the image, added more information, etc. All you have to do is press change image on the bottom left, select the new image, and it'll repopulate. Now next, you can also add custom labels. So if you want to add more information that isn't already showing, it's dead simple. And just like so, I've added new information, a new arrow pointing to a structure, and when I press edit cards, I can hit yes, and now all of my cards are updated to reflect these new changes, including this. So another great feature I like about this new plugin are the addition of fields. Now, these are the fields that will show up on all cards. You have a header that will show up at the top of the image and shows on the front side. This is great for a title, for example. The footer will be showing at the bottom of the image and also shows on the front. Use this for hints, mnemonics, prompts, etc. The remarks field will show only on the back, which is the answer side. Once you flip the card, this is good for additional information or details on the image. Sources appears on the back. Now, this is actually very useful because you can refer back to wherever you learned the information from should you ever need additional details. So you can put a website, you can put the lecture, etc. Tags work just like they did in the past, and the deck as well. Editing the cards updates those cards, and now when you review the cards, you have the header and the other additional information. Now, another field, if you actually press the edit down here, you'll be editing one card at a time. And you'll also see these two new fields, which are extra one and extra two. These are specific just to that specific card. So they won't show on all the cards like these other fields. These will show only on the specific one that you're reviewing. So some other features I really like about this plugin, there are hotkeys for just about everything you do. You can find them on the GitHub website. This add-on is also much safer to use. Image Occlusion 2.0 was great, but it wasn't very stable and it was subject to crashing or bugs. And moving forward, this add-on is future-ready. There are under-the-hood improvements that you don't need to really worry about. Just know that it will keep working for you in the future. So I have no personal stake in this plugin. I just think it's great and I highly recommend it. That is it for this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you like the video, make sure you press that like button. New videos every week, so hit subscribe if you haven't already. And I will see you guys in that next one.